Welcome to the streets. Where people are either invisible, cheating, or extremely salty. From garbage dumps to toaster bath avenues, there's something for everyone in this absolute shithole of a city. Streets is the newest map added to Tarkov and the closest representation to present-day Chicago one can get. You know, with the garbage, the state of public transportation, the armed hobos looting everything, and the active warzone in city center instigated by heavily armed SoundCloud rappers. The usual. God-tier loot spawns that after three nerfs are still busted beyond all sensibility, a chance for there to spawn 2 out of the 6 scav bosses at the same time, and a 100% chance for some motherfucker with TTV's name to call you a slur.
Shut up,
Notable locations being the car shop, the place this goofy looking motherfucker can spawn in, the makeshift jail that someone else has already reached before you, regardless of the spawn you got. This is the place you go to if you want to have a proper fight, but it seems to be infested with all manner of chads, rats, and other assorted mean men willing to kill you for a box of sugar. The Skybridge area near the jail has come to be known as Toaster Bath Avenue. It just being another clever method of self-die for those not either invisible or cheating. And here, you can play a fun game of will I get shot in the head when I run across this street? I usually lose that game. The underground parking garage would be a lovely place for my rat needs if it wasn't spawning spin-butting scavs in a continuous stream. I have had 15 kill raids, all scavs, from just under here. I have a feeling some genius at BSG mangled the spawn raids, wouldn't be surprised if that actually was the case. The Pinewood Hotel is known for spotting mediocre loot and this tracksuit wearing Tribaloski. If you hear a long burst from an RPK, go the other way. This aimbotting goblin is about to molest the laws of the physical universe by seeing out of that steel bucket he's strapped to his head. Did I mention that the Soviet relic from the 90s is only rated for pistol rounds? BSG does not seem to think so, as they think it's capable of stopping a 5.56 tungsten sable penetrator from point blank. If you somehow get the 10% chance for him to ruin your day, the Mosin PS round is capable of putting him in the forever box in a single hit to the head. Also, -12 PS12B will have the same effect for those with a bit more money to spare. Speaking about molesting the laws of physics, you can do that too. Simply go in between these two shit shacks, shove yourself in this corner, look somewhere in this general direction, and lean into the wall. You can now see every PMC and scav in the visible area. I don't know if this could be considered exploiting, but hey, they haven't fixed it yet. The hidey hole is a fun little place located under the stairs of the cinema. Its key has a guaranteed spawn in this hobo's dirty duffel bag. It has a few valuable spawns, you might get lucky with a bitcoin. The back avenues located around this area should be considered rat territory. Tight angles with a lot of exposed corridors and multiple levels make this ambush central. Unless you are accompanied by 4 heavily armed crack fiends with reaction times measured in microseconds, I suggest staying away. 8mm Magnum Buck is not conducive for one's health. The streamers are everywhere. In every raid there is at least one TTV wannabe chad that thinks putting TTV in his name is going to make him invincible to Magnum Buck. You'll know you killed one as you notice a friend request from a person between the levels of 38 and 51. The message will be one of 3 things. 1. A slur. 2. Something along the lines of you fucking rat. And 3. Nice cheats. Ignore these people and do it again. Not my fault they didn't check the top of a shipping container they didn't know you could get on top of. The ambush site can have plenty of loot and is a relatively high traffic area. However, the car shop compound has a 40 mic mic, overlooking the entire street. Just so you know. The extracts function as normal, with the exception of Klimov Street. It would appear that the Russian gopnik guarding this piece of road decided that if you don't put up a little light show for him, in the form of a green flare, you can put up a show for God instead. This map will stress your PC to the point of detonating if played for any lengthy periods of time. Does not matter how good your computer is, it's going to be brought to its non-existent knees by the will of Nikita alone. If you somehow manage to get the 5% spawn rate for this spin-botting piece of unbalanced garbage, 2 out of his 5 gods have been coded to run at you non-stop if you manage to aggro them. This includes the extract located down the street. Ask me how I know.
Spoke to folks about the past, you got to say.
Nice.